To all viewers of Toyotatimes Athletes Now, good evening. My name is Kyonosuke Morita, the main anchor of the program. My name is Takahiko Kozuka, the athlete anchor. Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games and Toyotatimes Athletes Now is now in day 16. 234 GTTAs, a global team Toyota athletes, come from 47 countries and region, and we will cheer them on with all our might. We are receiving happy messages, and they're continuing to come in. Joan Pereira for Portugal Triathlon, Gabrielle Detti, Italy Swimming, Laura Messina, Paris Swimming, Brian from France Athletics, and Eddie Black
Toyota
from
family. It's very important for
Artistic Gymnastics of Canada. Hi everyone, this is Gabrielle Detti. I wanted to say hello to the whole Toyota family and the global Toyota team athlete who took part in Tokyo Olympic Games.
I'm a professional surfer from Peru. I want to say thank you to my Toyota family for all the support, for all the vibes that you guys sent me during my event. Even though we didn't have public, I had so many messages from people from Peru, from all Latin America, supporting me. So it was a super nice event, one of the best experiences of my life. So I want to say thank you to Toyota for all the support and keep watching my events. Thank you guys.
Hello everyone, let me introduce myself. My name is Olivier Bayon. I represented France in the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games. I would like to thank the whole Toyota family for the support they gave me throughout the Games. It is true that these Olympic Games were a bit particular with the health context. It will remain an unforgettable experience. Thanks to you for everything.
Hi, it's Ellie Black, three-time Olympic gymnast, and I'm coming home from Tokyo. And I just wanted to say a massive thank you to my Toyota family. Thank you so much for cheering me on and supporting me in my journey to Tokyo. For my Corolla, I love it so much. It really has made all the difference in getting to and from training to my physio appointments, everything that I needed to be at my best for Tokyo. So thank you so much for the support.
So, a lot of messages from throughout the world, thank you messages, thank you from our side as well. And in addition to the videos, we have received a lot of comments. Swimming America, Caleb Dressel, he brought back 5 gold medals. TMNA's Jack mentioned that in Orland, Toyota members cheered on the athletes with the athletes' families. And from athletics, the United States, Michael Norman.
I appreciate my Toyota family from all over the world. I definitely feel the love and support. ということで、世界中のトヨタファミリーの皆さん、ありがとう。大きな愛と応援を感じました。ということで、本当に。
So it's so nice to know our support and cheers reach them, and that makes us want to cheer them on more. So let us continue to cheer on the Toyota family till the end. Now on SNS, use hashtag ToyotaTimesLive to send your message to the athletes. The Olympic Games is nearing the end, and let us give them more cheers. And to the athletes who finished their competition, let us send our appreciation to them. And to our viewers, always thank you very much for your comments. And we're waiting for more today. So Toyota Times Athletes Now is brought to you every day from 7 p.m. and it will be archived on YouTube after the live broadcast, and we have a simultaneous translation on the English channel, and the English version will be uploaded several hours after the broadcast. So if you miss it, please watch them in your spare time. This is today's feature story, Breakthrough, Toyota Athletes in Women's Basketball. So the new sports 3x3 basketball, MAWULI and Yamamoto will be appearing live, and they brought to us a lot of excitement during the first part of the Olympic Games, and they will look back on the competition, and they will talk about the five-a-side basketball who are going to face a historic big match tomorrow. Now let us look at the performance of Toyota athletes yesterday and today. The GTTA athletes and countries are shown in red, modern pentathlon women's individual, Kovács from Hungary, bronze medal. Congratulations. For her, this was her first Olympics medal. Wrestling women's freestyle 53 kilogram, it was a fierce battle. Mukaida from Japan won a gold medal, a catch-up from behind gold medal. In basketball, women's semifinal, they won against France and they have secured a medal for them. A 60 GTTAs provided a superb performance, and in the finals they will be fighting against America, who won 7 golds in a row. A football men, they lost to Mexico in the bronze medal match. They weren't able to get a medal, but they won against strong countries and they performed very well throughout the games. Athletics women's marathon, Tejera from Peru was 27th. Next, rhythmic gymnastics women's group all around. Sugimoto and Takenaka from Japan, they were 7th in the qualifying round, and tomorrow will be finals. In the interview, that there was tears and frustration of their performance, but let's look forward to the finals. Beach volleyball men's final, they won against ROC 220. Mol Sorum won gold medal. Congratulations. So this is going to be the fourth Norwegian beach volleyball gold. Canoe sprint, men's canoe single 1,000 meter. Fuxa from Czech was a fifth. Women's kayak 4,500 meters. Hungary's Cipes and Bondoni, they already have silver and bronze medals respectively, and in their final competition they won gold. Congratulations. So the number of events we'll be introduced to you is going down every day, but all of them are performing very well.
Now, today's special feature, breakthrough Toyota athletes in women's basketball. Yes, truly a breakthrough was brought by women's basketball. Full court basketball, which advanced to the finals for the first time, and 3x3 basketball, which made an Olympic debut in Tokyo, both brought excitement, leading the way in Olympic Games Tokyo 2020. Today we'd like to welcome two GTTA who showed great performance in 3x3 basketball. They are now online with us. MAWULI Stephanie and YAMAMOTO Mai. Good evening. Konbanwa, good evening. Yes, right after your competition, on day 6, we had a special feature on basketball and you sent us your messages to Toyotatimes Athletes Now. Thank you. Thank you. Are you watching our program? Yes. Well, I felt a moment between you guys, but yes, you are watching us. Maybe we would like to ask questions to you. Well, thank you for being with us today. Seeing your smiles, you are making us smile too. Thank you. After you sent us your messages, we started to receive more and more messages from GTTA, and I think the circle spread out between us. First, we'd like to look back on your competition in 3x3. This shows the recap of Japan national team women's basketball 3x3. First match against ROC, you lost, but after that you showed stellar performance, especially your fourth match against France, world rank number one. You stunned them. How do you reflect yourselves? Yes, it was really hot. I mean, the temperature was hot, the climate was hot. However, I thought that we really need our physical strength. So I think we were able to win and we are very, very happy. Well, against world rank number one, France, how were they? Yes, before the actual Olympic, we did lose against them. So I think it was like a revenge match, but individual performance is really good, the French team. That is why we thought that we really need to tighten ourselves. If we are on the defensive side, we really worked on it together as a collective power. And you had a win against USA too. USA earned a gold medal, but the only team which beat USA were you guys, the Japan team. How was your match against USA? Yes, we knew that they are strong, and it was the first time to face them. So I think that is why we were able to work on them with our full strength without having much things in our mind, because it was our first time facing them. Yes, I went to an interview in the stadium, but when Stephanie came to these basketball court, I thought that really the atmosphere changed. Oh, this is actually the picture of you in the match against USA. Yamamoto-san, do you also feel that? Yes, during the match too, she shouts, and I think if she really heightens the emotions with her wonderful plays. And at the, I think we are really helped by the support and the voices of our teammates too. Yeah, Yamamoto-san, I think seeing you via Zoom, you look very cute, but in an actual match, I feel that you are super powerful and you push into and get closer to the hoop. So do you try to force yourself in and show your strength? I think my weapon is speed. That is why against my opponent, I try to always think I should be speedy so I will never lose against them. Yes, you showed really great performance. And we have questions, comments. Stephanie, during the Olympic period, your hairstyle so colorful and cool. You have black hair again now. Yes, yeah, I took that off. Oh, it was just for the Olympic. Yep. A limited edition during the Olympic. Yeah, so cool, the color, Olympic color. Yes, that's right. I really wanted to show myself in the Olympics, stand out. Yeah, when did you come up with this idea of your hairstyle? I came up with this idea, I think, 1 week before the opening. I thought, yeah, I want to stand out with my color of my hair, and I heard that some people started watching 3x3 with my hairstyle, so I thought I did something good for the sport too. 3x3 is a new sport in Tokyo 2020. I think there are many new fans, spectators. What is the attraction and the fun of 3x3 that you were able to communicate? I think because our court is smaller than usual basketball, it was easy to see even through television. So maybe older people told me it was easy to watch your match. So I think all people of all generations watched us because the match is, it's very speedy and we score quickly. That is why the match moves fast. And I think that is why many people were able to watch us. Yes. Because it's about half the size of a 5x5 court and 10 minutes is your play time. So I think it was really fun for us to watching you. But players after the match, I thought that you really looked tired out. Is it very hard, 10 minutes match, putting in your full strength? Yes, compared to full court basketball, we are running a lot. Of course, full court basketball, they run a lot, but they sometimes stop. But in 3x3, I think we never stop. Maybe stop only like 10 seconds or so. It's like we're always out of air. Really breathtaking. And you had 2 matches a day. Yeah, it must have been very intense for you. But you were able to win against USA. And in the quarterfinal, you matched against France again and lost, but I thought that you were really close. We thought you might have won. How did you feel in the quarterfinal? France, I think we felt that they were really determined to win, different from the preliminary round, and their shots started to become more precise. More and more goals. That is why it was difficult to bring the wave to our side. So looking back, recapping all the matches, how would you evaluate yourselves? Well, it was our first Olympic. That is why maybe we could not do everything that we wanted to do in the Olympic, but many people watched us, and I think we were able to enjoy ourselves to a certain extent. So I think we were able to grow through the Olympic. How about you, Yamamoto-san? Yes, it was my first experience, and I think I could have done better. However, there were good days and bad days. And of course, in those good days, I could do well. I want to turn that to a positive power for the future. Yes, people really got interested and enjoyed your performance, 3x3 basketball. Yeah, my friends who watched 3x3 basketball told me, I want to try 3x3. And they said, Kozuka-san, let's do it with me. Yeah, I'm sure this sport is spreading and many people are interested now.
So, this time we don't have a lot of information about the athletes' village. So we want to ask you, what was the atmosphere at the athletes' village? So it was within a fence. It was more or less like a theme park. So we were able to enjoy our stay there. There was a nail salon, and there was a beauty parlor. And the coach and our coach went to the beauty parlor, and the person who did her hair was a woman in her 80s. So it was really a village. The result of the haircut, I think we can imagine the result of the haircut from your smile. Now the picture here, this is from the athlete's ball. You have a telephone box? Yes. The UK delegation, it was below the UK delegation's building. And maybe because it was insogenic. Yes, it is. Looks very nice. Thank you. So one of the comments that came in was, did you ride the e-palette? Yes. How was it? It was like a regular bus. It comes on time. And it is automated, and if a person crosses in front, it stops. And it was very cool, and we had fun. We envy you. We had a feature story on the e-palette, and we heard about the difficulties that were faced. And behind the e-palette, there is a lot of support from our Toyota members. So the e-palette was actually welcomed at the athletes' village. So how was the food at the athletes' village? It was very good. We were able to choose from among food from many countries in the world, and we weren't able to take any ourselves. We were served. What did you like? What did you have frequently? Takoyaki, the Japanese Osaka octopus snack. So they do it for you? Yes, I think so. And some of the overseas athletes were taking about 10 at a time. So for our overseas athletes, it will be an opportunity to try Japanese food. I think we received a comment from the president saying the color of your hair is not nice. So from time to time, I try out a new hairstyle. So for this program, the president often sends us a message. So he must have been watching, so he has to know about the hairstyle. Now let us move on to the next topic. Our Toyota teammates are going to face a big match. They will be winning at least silver. MAWULI Evelyn, Nagaoka, Miyoshi, Takada, Akaho, and Todo. Six GTTAs are in the Japanese team, and they've come to the finals. How were you watching the semifinals yesterday? We were watching together. The first quarter, the opponent was very strong, but from the second quarter onwards, they changed tactics and they made sure that the flow or the was always with Japan. So it was the teamwork and the trust they have in each other was very good. I looked at the Twitter from Stephanie. It says, "Yatta," meaning we did it. Why did you have a question mark at the end? Did you make a mistake? Oh, I was so excited. I made a mistake and put in a question mark instead of an exclamation mark. But more so than ourselves, for basketball women's team, you know that going to finals is just a great achievement. So the times are changing. Japan is getting stronger. And you might think that the foreign country, foreign teams are getting weaker, but that's not the case. The Japanese level has gone up significantly. Let's look back on the performance of the Japanese team. They lost against the USA, but after all these matches, they're now at the finals. And what is so good about the Japanese team this time? There are a lot of assists given to other players, like passing to other athletes for them to shoot. But they have the power to make the shot, simple layup. And they do all the things very well, and that's going to have an impact on the opponent, like a body blow. So your offense is like making the opponent uncomfortable. The opponent will become tired, but the Japanese team continues that tactic. And maybe the Japanese team is running too much. So it's a very Japanese way of playing. For Stephanie, your sister Evelyn is doing her best. Have you communicated with her? Yes, every night. So always focus on yourselves. She always plays her own role and comes back, and I think that's great about her. Ms. Yamamoto, is there any GTTA you are particularly impressed with? Ms. Takada, the captain of the team, what's so great about her? So her shots, when they matter, are so good. Look at this picture. So as captain, she has the power to unite the team, and if you listen to the interview after the game, they're so cool. Just watching Takada-san tells her how good the atmosphere is within the team. So, is she always a person full of captaincy? Well, regardless of the age or seniority, she's a good communicator, and I always talk with her, and she's a very nice person. So they've already made history, but there's one more to go. So, and it's against the United States, and they're now here, so we want them to win. But how do you think they'll be able to win? So in the previous match against the United States, they were doing very well up to the middle of the latter half, but they lost because the Japanese team started to dwindle toward the end. But this time, I think they should be able to win. You're nodding, Yamamoto-san. Do you agree? Yes. So everything Stephanie says is right. But I think this momentum is very important. Japan has the momentum. So, of course, we have high expectations. Now, lastly, now including these six athletes, there are GTTAs or Toyota Family athletes who have upcoming matches at the Olympic Games and Paralympic Games, so please give them a message. The Tokyo Olympic Games, we have that Olympic Games only once, so please demonstrate your capabilities to the full, enjoy the match, and I believe that will bring about good results. So please enjoy your match. Do your best. Thank you very much. You might think this is the end, but there is one request from our side. You watch this program, right? Yeah. Do you know what is being done? Yes. So you've practiced? So let me explain to you. The cheer-on song of this program was made by Naoto Intiraimi, and we collect the athletes' voices to be included in the music. Mito of archery and Yamamoto of the pole vaulter has already given us their voices, so we want your voice as well. So we'll show you the VTR, the video from Naoto Intiraimi. Just this part. Say oh oh twice. Let's try. So that's good. So I'll mute myself. So do it yourself. That sounds good. Can you raise your voice a bit? A bit louder, please. That's so good. Thank you so much. Thank you for accepting this offer. That was perfect. And you look so nice together, and it was very synchronized. You watched the program. We can tell that you were very well prepared. I understand you have practiced this, and you must have been very tired, but thank you very much for today, and thank you very much for the nice performance during the Olympic Games. That was Stephanie Mauri and Mai Yamamoto. From the beginning of September, the league matches will start again, and it will be a good opportunity to watch the top performance worldwide. So please start watching basketball with this Olympic Games, and tomorrow we'll have the finals. Today's feature was a breakthrough to the athletes in women's basketball.
Finally, tonight and tomorrow, GTTA schedule. Yes, tonight, athletics. Women's 10,000 meters Lahti from Sweden. So that's the only sport tonight. And tomorrow, athletics, Japan, Hattori. He said, please watch me the last 15 minutes. And also, let's look at his dual water bottle. Cheer on him. Women's volleyball, Robinson, final, USA against Brazil. It's a gold medal match. Let's support them. Rhythmic gymnastics team final, Sugimoto captain and Takenaka. Team Japan, it will be their last performance. Give it your best shot. And Kitada-san, who has been watching Sugimoto-san, she gave a comment in the latter part of the performance. I was very excited to see you, and I am very happy I can see you again in the final tomorrow. So I'm going to support you with my full effort. I'm very, very excited. We will be supporting you too. Next, cycling track, Omnium. team pursued silver and Madison gold. Kenny has already earned two medals, and this will be for three consecutive golds in Omnium. And Belgium, Kopecky, she's been road track. Will she be able to grasp a medal in her last sport? Basketball. As you all know, tomorrow will be the final. MAWULI Evelyn, MIYOSHI Naho, NAGAOKA MOEKO, AKAHO HIMAWARI, TAKADA MAKI, and TODO NANAKO. Six members of GTTA, we will be cheering on you. Final match against America, United States gold medal match from 11:30 a.m. Tomorrow is the final match. Let's cheer all of us together. I became overexcited a little bit. Yes, I'm excited too. We will be sharing the results with in tomorrow's Toyotatimes Athletes Now, and you'll be able to look at the results through our special website in Toyotatimes Athletes Now. Also access the athletes' SNS. If you mention them with an at sign, maybe you will be directly connected to athletes. And I was also able to connect with athletes too. Yes, whenever you support athletes via SNS, don't forget hashtag TOYOTATIMESLIVE. Let's become one team through our support. From 7 p.m., it was the 16th day of TOYOTATIMES Athletes Now. Yes, we had a very, very heated atmosphere and two guests, and we were able to understand more about basketball and where we should watch out for tomorrow. We are receiving lots of comments today too. So we have, I think, teammates commenting from MAWULI Stephanie, YAMAMOTO, my teammates, I think. I want to know about the Olympic Village and Athletes Village. Well, I think please ask them directly. And from YouTube, Hayakawa-san commented, a wonderful smile, MAWULI and YAMAMOTO. Thank you. Yes, we became cheerful too. And Urima-san, let's keep the momentum and let's go for tomorrow. On Instagram, NGS. Stephanie and YAMAMOTO watching you too. We could see that you really have a great, good relationship. Yeah. You were like poking each other and having fun. A very cheerful atmosphere. Yes. Yep, we have a really good relationship too, right, Kozuka-san? Yes. Well done. And congratulations, Stephanie and YAMAMOTO Mai. Yes, and we were able to understand the attraction of 3x3 basketball. We want to continue to support them. Tomorrow's special feature. Every single story for the Tokyo 2020 Games. Gold medalist Atsumi Goto Yamazaki Mine will be joining us in order to look back GTTA's Olympic Games Tokyo 2020. And Kozuka-san, Nagasaki-san, and Akio Toyoda, our president, all of the members will be here. President Toyoda said, you commented, you, the OO of MAWULI and YAMAMOTO are great. Yeah. A very fatherly a message. We would like our father, president, to recap the Olympic, and he's been supporting us through comment almost every day. Many of you might have communicated through the comment. And tomorrow's our last day of Olympic program, so we would like to collect questions and messages to the president. During the ending song, you are able to comment on YouTube. So if you have any questions to the president, please comment. And be sure to come to our program tomorrow. In the ending of our program, you see a familiar picture. We have movies of support from Toyota Workplaces and the original cheer-on song from Naoto, Inti Raimi. Tomorrow, we heard that there will be an upgraded version of Naoto Inti Raimi song. Oh, and we received a comment from Naoto too, right? Oh, we are going to have a comment. We already, last time, two times ago, towards the president? You forgot? Okay, I'm sorry. It didn't ring a bell on me, but, yep. We'll try to align ourselves. Tomorrow's Toyotatimes athletes now will be even more colorful. Let's see you again tomorrow. It was Morita Kyonosuke, your main anchor, and Kozuka Takahiko, your athlete presenter. See you again, 7 p.m., 1 Toyota.
Oh yeah, yo, we are teammates.